Yes Day, starring Jennifer Garner, is the story of an epic day in the life of the Torres family when, for 24 hours, kids make the rules.
It's Yes Day!
But is having a Yes Day a real thing? Is Yes Day a true story?
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
No.
Yes.
Yes Day is inspired by the book Yes Day by Amy Krouse Rosenthal and Tom Lichtenheld. In the book, a young boy gets to do whatever he asks for the entire day.
This is the best day ever!
Yay!
Yay!
Jennifer Garner's 3-year-old daughter loved the book so much, her family started doing Yes Days every year.
Who's ready for Yes Day?
Oftentimes, because of the busy schedules, activities, and work, the baseline for parents becomes saying no.
No way, no how, not by a long shot, under no circumstances, not in a million years, no.
That's parenting.
But Jennifer Garner found that there was a great power in saying yes.
Oh, yes! Yeah!
What she found was that by giving them one day that was all their own, her family felt happier and more connected. In 2017, Jennifer posted an exhausted picture of herself in the aftermath of her family's Yes Day celebration. The photo sparked so much interest, the Yes Day idea became a viral phenomenon.
Is it crazy I'm already looking forward to our next Yes Day?
What's that?
We made a list of our 5 big asks. For the day to be a success, we have to make it through all 5.
I love a list.
The big asks the Torres kids have planned for their Yes Day get pretty wild.
Windows down!
In real life, when kids make the rules, there have been some seriously fun adventures, too. One of the first events on the Torres kids' list is going to an ice cream parlor. There, they chow down on the ridiculously large ice cream sundae known as the Gut Buster.
We'd like that one, please.
The Gut Buster?
Yeah, definitely!
There are monster sundaes all around the world with names like the Beast, the Vermonster, the Kitchen Sink, and the Trainwreck. But Yes Day's Super Sundae is probably based on the Boonville Bellyache. Carrie Lynn's ice cream parlor in Boonville, Missouri is known for serving the Boonville Bellyache. It's a huge bowl filled with 16 scoops of ice cream, 10 brownie bites, 2 chocolate chip cookies, every single topping that they offer, and a big pile of whipped cream.
Hey, it's $40.
Not if you finish it in under 30 minutes. Then it's free.
That is true.
Just like in Yes Day, if you down the Boonville Bellyache in 30 minutes, it's free. You also get a t-shirt and a photo on the Wall of Fame if you survive.
Section 10 of the contract says vomiting voids the win.
Keep it down, babe. You can do it.
There's a bucket right there.
Good. It's fine. You got this.
You have to hold it. Oh. Oh.
In the book, the young boy invents his own game. But the movie takes this idea to a whole new level when the Torres family plays Kablowie.
What's Kablowie?
It's cut for the flag, meets paintball, meets a butt ton of Kool-Aid.
The game was created for the movie, and over 55,000 water balloons were thrown in this epic battle. In real life, the largest water balloon fight ever consisted of 9,000 students at the University of Kentucky. Over 175,000 water balloons were used during the fight. That's over 3 times as many.
I love the smell of Kool-Aid in the morning.
The Torres family takes a detour to Magic Mountain Amusement Park during their Yes Day and spends some time on some monstrous roller coasters.
Why did I say yes to this, Katie?
In real life, the greatest number of different roller coasters ridden in a single day is a whopping 74. In 2001, 4 friends rode roller coasters in 10 parks in 4 different U.S. states along the East Coast. In order to save time, they used a helicopter to travel between the different parks. And they probably didn't have time to get in a fight over a pink gorilla. Later on, Nando throws what he calls a nerd party.
Who's ready to make some science miracles?
The kids fill the house with foam, but could you actually fill your whole house with foam?
Oh no, what have I done?
In real life, the 13th birthday party of a kid named Fletcher Rawlinson had even more science miracles than Yes Day's nerd party. With the help of YouTubers Mark Rober and Science Bob, Fletcher set a world record when they set off the largest foam explosion experiment ever. Using a fast-growing type of foam called Devil's Toothpaste, their foam explosion shot over 60 feet into the air and created over 72,000 gallons of foam. Meaning you could easily have enough foam to fill your whole house.
Mama, look, more foam!
While Yes Day may not actually be a true story, many families have started making this a yearly tradition. What would you do on a Yes Day? Tell us in the comments below and watch Yes Day on Netflix now.